And Australian First Treatment is making a splash, helping people with serious injuries to improve their mobility and their confidence. Today, reporter Reese D'Alessandro went along to take part.
For someone recovering from or living with a serious injury, the bottom of a swimming pool is possibly the last place you'd plan to be, but not here. A small South Australian team of expert scuba divers reckon it's the best road to not only recovery, but to better health.
34-year-old Nick Schumi is as inspirational as he is determined. He has cerebral palsy, uses a wheelchair almost all of the time, and is just one of many taking a unique plunge in North Adelaide. Nick's first session was more than 3 years ago. Today, he's coming in with me and is lifted into the shallow end where the experience begins. That's cold.
Checking she's a full tank.
I hope so.
First, a game of torpedo darts, certainly not my strong suit. So we upgrade to an underwater cannon, then straight from a Bond film, a personal propeller. But it's what Nick does in the deep end that's truly remarkable.
There's so many things that I can do in the water that I just can't do on land. I use a manual wheelchair to get around, but the water is just a freeing environment for me and so many others.
It's officially called immersion therapy, and Peter Wilson is its founder. Pete overcame his own personal struggles with both physical injuries and mental illness to start a business. Determined too is the result of his own recovery story.
Yeah, so it was 2007, had a major motorcycle accident while I was at work, which almost cost me my life. And it took me about 12 months to recover, to be able to stand upright again. And, you know, I'm probably still 13 years later, still somewhat recovering from some of the issues that's left me with.
His idea was to take the fun of open water scuba diving and bring it indoors.
After my accident, I sort of decided that I was going to learn to dive, but also learned that it was really restrictive. The medical process that you have to be able to meet was quite restrictive. The environment itself is quite restrictive.
Nick is just one of Peter's success stories, and he's loved it so much, he now works at Determined 2, helping other participants overcome their fears. The program's so remarkable, senior lecturer of clinical exercise physiology, Dr. Kay Davison, is now putting it under the microscope.
We see changes in limb function, so range of motion, control of limbs, potentially some strength changes. Some of that translates to on land, so people that are actually getting better function when they return to their normal daily activity on land.
And it's not just people with physical disabilities or acquired injuries who benefit. There are also massive positives when it comes to mental health. So significant, war veterans are also getting on board as part of their treatment for PTSD.
Determined too.
On top of being one of Australia's first organisations recognised under the new and rigorous NDIS Quality Safeguards Commission, Determined 2 is going from strength to strength, recently recognised at the Telstra Business Awards.
The reality is it's not our disability that defines us or our injuries at all. It's the way that we choose to face those challenges in life.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.